Hi and welcome. Yes, you did. That's not too surprising since our time difference is rather big. Anyway, how are you doing? I hope you're doing well today. Today, as you can tell from the title, we are playing The Murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. And we have about 1 minute until we 2 minutes until we start. So I'm just gonna quickly do a couple things and just get things set up. But other than that, how are you doing today? Going to sleep soon though, like in an hour? That's fair enough. That is definitely fair enough. I hope you've had a good day. Salut, Sibi. Who the heck killed Sonic? I have no clue who killed Sonic. I haven't actually played this game before, but I've seen a lot of people play it. So I kind of figured, why not give it a shot? Salut, Shibin. I venit in flux. And yes, I hope we have a good time. Do I really want to wait for the rest of the time to go? I mean, it's not like I'm waiting for anyone. What am I saying? Oh, it's Romanian for welcome to a basic... No, it's Romanian. It's basically just a greeting. I don't know, because all these different streamers just have this catchphrase, like, bro fist if you're PewDiePie or something like that, and you just, like, have that one intro that they use all the time, and I'm trying to come up with something. But anyway, I never think I heard Romanian? Damn. Yeah, I mean, it is this strange language, and not that commonly spoken from what I'm aware of. But anyway, I'm guessing we might as well just get it on and start with it. So let's go. Let's see who killed Sonic. Phew, I made it on the train 50 minutes ahead of schedule. Oh, I'm sorry, but the logo will be postponed. That's all right. Trust me, you're doing me such a big favor by even helping me with literally anything. So honestly, it's everything you do is really appreciated. After I get it, we will finally start advertising Discord. Thank you so much, and I appreciate all your help. It's honestly so helpful. Obviously, because it's help. Just need to... I think I'll move chat to the top right corner. Okay, there we go. There we go. Phew, I made it on the train 15 minutes ahead of schedule. So far, so good for my first day on the job. I'm trying to figure out, what kind of animal is this? A cat? No, it looks like a fox in terms of coloring. Oh, I totally forgot my name tag isn't ready yet. I should make one. I'll just sign my name here. And hello, my name is, I mean, I don't care either way whether people call me Flexity or whether they use my actual name, so I'll just sign my actual name. Eliza Lee. That's my name. Eliza Lee. Did I spell that right? Yes, I did. Hope passengers can read my scribble. Okay, time to find out who... Yeah, let's see. Who killed him? The dining car. It's actually got really good graphics and good transitioning from what I can see so far. Uh-oh, am I nervous? Is this the first day on the job, jitters? No, I appear to be very calm. Working the train's dining car can't be so bad. Come on, Eliza Lee, shake it off. I'm guessing we just slapped ourselves. Eliza Lee, did I just see you hitting yourself? Yeah, I also noticed that it looks surprisingly good seeing it for the first time. Yeah, I got this game off Steam, if you want to play it yourself. It's sort of a fan game, but also an official game in a way. Mr. Conductor, sir! How are you doing this morning? Oh my god, is he Santa? He's Santa. Ho ho ho. Quite alright myself, though feeling a little bittersweet. Is everything alright? Is that because you're a sweetie? That seems a little strange to say to your boss on the first day. Or ever. So I'm gonna go, is everything alright? Plus it's considerate. Well, truth be told, not really. Alas, today's my last day as a conductor. I'm retiring after 32 wonderful years. That's a long time. Time for me and the Mirage Express, which I'm guessing is the train we're on then, to say goodbye to one another. Oh, congratulations on retirement, sir. That's such a weird thing to congratulate someone on. Thank you. My wife is very excited about it. She already got our plane tickets to Spagonia locked. Our shower's been on the fritz, so I'm excited to use the hotels. I can see why his wife is excited. I can see too. The heck is Spagonia? I'm pretty sure it's a place in the Sonic franchise? Question mark? I don't know, I've only played like the old games of Sonic, so I wouldn't really know. Enough of my quibbles. Today's your first day working the dining car. Here's the menu for today. Okay. The menu is added to our inventory, so this is our inventory here. I can open the inventory at any time to view items I've received. I should look over the menu carefully. Okay, let's look over the menu. So they only have three things for the options. Chili dog, which I know is Sonic's favorite food. I suck at Sonic lore, so I have no clue. I played Sonic Adventures when young, good childhood. Yeah. I think anybody who grew up with Sonic had a good childhood. Well, mostly. Sort of. Maybe not. So they only sell chili dogs, ramen, and chicken cordon bleu. That is interesting. Why do you look so nervous? All we have on the train is a microwave. A microwave, really? No stoves on the train. That is gonna make cooking so easy. Though I'm sure microwave is all you need in for life, for good God's sake. No, I like cooking. Cooking's fun. I've noticed that a lot of streamers cannot cook. Like, I see cooking competitions all the time that people do, and just I've noticed that so many just can't cook. Which, that is, I might as well mention, for people watching back on the VOD and for you, I have some sub goals set up, so, microwave has better changed my mind. I will cook for you one day, and yeah, I will change your mind. One of my current sub goals is if I hit it either for follow goals here on Twitch, since I haven't got sub set up, or on YouTube, if I hit on either of them, I will be doing that sub goal. And if I've already reached that sub goal on the other platform, then I'll make another sub goal for that. So basically YouTube and Twitch both have their own sub goal set, and a cooking stream is one of those. So eventually we will be getting a cooking stream and maybe a cooking competition. Already trying to poison me? I guess I didn't do enough yet. Oh, trust me. I would never do that to you. I would never poison anyone. No, I actually love cooking. Cooking's fun. I can cook rather well. Lies. Oh no, he's catching on to me. Though I'm sure a little quiz is in order. Which of these do we serve in the dining car? Well, obviously it's this one, it's the fancy one. Because we don't serve crab ragoon or spicy grilled picky. Which I'm guessing that's supposed to be like something like a pickle? Ding ding ding! You can read the menu, okay. Yes, I actually got my two new glasses today, so I can actually see. I'd say the difference in my old glasses to my current, since my prescription changed so much, it's basically, imagine an old school TV and you immediately just upgrade to like ultra high definition ULED TV. That's the kind of difference, because I couldn't like read like a couple feet ahead of me, and now I can see like so clearly. Damn, she can read? Yes, I can read now.
Everything is so clear. I can even see Superman who's staring at me. Anyway, a little about the vessel. This is a state-of-the-art high-speed smart train with all the latest gadgets. So I'm guessing it's basically this world's version of a bullet train? This train can really handle anything you throw at it. We've had a lot of adventures together, me and this train. It's not easy to leave. This train is like your child, then, I'm guessing. Oh, I was really confused for a second. Actually, I do like DC and Marvel. I have a Deadpool calendar, which was rather expensive, but it's still beautiful. But I do prefer DC, and I love comic books. I'm definitely a comic book nerd, but I prefer DC, especially the Bat Family. But I do like both. Like, most people will argue and say, oh no, only one's better than the other. No, I like both. Gosh, I'm sleepy. My brain doesn't want to stop. I don't care. Oh, you don't have to be here if you're tired. Please sleep. Your mental health and, you know, physical health are important. So if you get tired, it's all right. You don't have to stay here. You're not obligated to stay here. This train is exclusively used for events. It's not a passenger train. I remember that from the interview. Yeah, both are nice. DC Flash and Batman comics are nice. Nightwing ones are good as well. Yes! Yes! Thank you. Thank you. Finally, someone with taste. Actually, some of my most prized comic books. I only have a few. Are one from the 1960s, which is a very old one, which is almost kind of falling apart, but like I'm taking good care of it. And some of the new mint condition 52s. I'm not as fussed on the newer ones. But I have no taste. Though, Ophelia, you have good taste. No, you have good taste. The Flash is really cool. And so is Batman and Nightwing. Admittedly, my favorite Robin is actually Jason Todd, but, you know, I like all of them. Plus, I mean, Dick Grayson, his evolution has been quite interesting. Anyway, I won't give any spoilers in case you haven't seen certain things. Jason Todd, yes, 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 I love Jason Todd. His whole evolution through, like, his character arcs, dying, living, that's probably a spoiler. I don't know, I honestly should just do a stream where I just fangirl over different comic books. I don't know, I love so many comic books. Also, my favorite comic book artist is Dexter Soy. I love the art styles he used. Granted, certain scenes just don't fit exactly right because it looks a little like... But like 99.9% of his art I love. It's beautiful. I could literally fangirl over like comic books all day, but like... I remember that from the interview. What's the event today? A murder mystery party. Nothing better than some thrills to end my tenure as a conductor. Guests will be funneled here to the dining car as a home base, so to speak. I'll be with you to gather tickets, but after that you'll be on your own. Also, just another quick side note, I have a Justice League of America huge, like, rollout mat for my, like, desk mat for, like, I have my keyboard and mouse on, and it is huge and it is beautiful, and I love it. Also, I'm super psyched for the Blue Beetle movie. So I'll need you to do everything in your power to make sure our guests are paying, our paying guests are well taken care of. Understood? Final question: what do you think about The Boys? I haven't seen it yet. So many people have been talking about it. I haven't actually seen it yet. I haven't had the chance. I'll make you proud, sir, because I can't afford to lose this job. Sounds kind of desperate and needy. Glad this old man can rest easy. Doors to the Mirage Express are opening. All aboard! Ooh, I like that design. The colors are nice. It does look like a bullet train, though. That's Amy Rose. Wow, this train is incredible! What fascinating tech. Of course Tails would be all for this. admittedly, as an OG fan of Sonic, like, only playing, like, the old school games, I'm not too sure who Vector is. You're right, Tails. I can get used to staying on a train like this. If anything, he looks more like a bad guy than a good guy, if I'm honest. What do you all expect? You know I always go all out for my birthday party, so I'm guessing it's her birthday then. I'm so glad they finally are doing something with Blue Beetle. Gosh, the concept of him was always so cool. OP. Retractable armor that can do almost anything. Yes! Plus, with a lot of those characters, like with Venom as well, I like the characters that have like the symbiotes that kind of fuse with their body. I don't know, I've always kind of loved that kind of aspect in characters. Plus, one of the first kind of Latin characters. And I don't know, he actually was one of the good series. I do like the original Blue Beetle, but I also like the successor, his successor. I mean, from track record, for me personally, all of Blue Beetle, both past and current, have kind of, they just mesh well together for me. You know I always go all out for my birthday party. This train's as elegant as you are, Amy. Can't promise I won't take anything, though. Calm down there, Rouge. See, I always thought that was spelled rogue, like pronounced rogue, but apparently it's Rouge. Did I not just catch you? Bro, if you start about Venom, my fanboy childhood is gonna be remembered. Trust me, we honestly need to have a long, long conversation about comic books because all my friends are really girly girls or my guy friends are all busy, so I don't have anybody to talk to about this, and I love comic books so much. I mean, the only issue is, over where I am, there are no comic book stores near me, and there are no good comic book stores, and they're so expensive. That's why I just, when I go back to America, I'm going to comic book stores, and I'd say one of my number one bucket list idea dream things is to go to a comic con. I know most people think, oh my god, that's so nerdy, that's so weird, but no, I want to go to a comic con. I want to see so many things. Anyway. Sorry. The old show Spider-Man, The Amazing Spider-Man, where Venom was red and blue on the edges, was my childhood perfect hero person, even though he wasn't one. No, yeah, exactly. So many people forget that. Actually, to be fair, a lot of original like villain characters in a lot of different series, both DC and Marvel, have actually become like more, I wouldn't exactly say anti-hero, but along that kind of line. Like a lot of bad guys like Bane are no longer considered really villains, if you get what I mean. Plus with the whole Venom movie, I mean, can you really consider Venom, well, that version of Venom, to be evil? Anyway, I've seen a lot of people simp for Venom, which, from the fan art I've seen, like, there's a lot of R34 Venom, which is kind of concerning. But I've only found that because of Pinterest, by accident. I like the movie, it looked better than Spider-Man 3. I wasn't exactly too fussed on, like, the original Spider-Man movies. Like, it wasn't too bad, but I don't know. The Spider-Man movies never kind of stuck with me. I preferred the comic books. And but yes, I did like the Venom movie, the first one. I haven't seen the second, so no spoilers, but I look forward to seeing it. I'm definitely gonna have to plan a stream where we just literally just talk about comic books and comic book characters because, woo. We don't touch symbiote stuff when it comes to the artist. Oh no, exactly. So many interesting takes on them, right? Oh dear. Calm down there. It can be terrifying. Yeah, I actually saved one, just for, like, show a friend, because she didn't believe me. And, oh boy, you know what, we're not gonna go into this. You know what terrifying is. Come. No, I would never make six. Hey, did you know that immediately tries to change topic. Twitter makes things so bad. You want it. Nah, I'm missing for Jason Todd, man. Not just because I like his character design and everything, but I don't know, a lot about his character is actually really interesting and relatable. Also, when it comes to- Your brain is dying, bro, same. When it comes to character design, though, I know there's kind of a debate, sort of, about this, but I actually prefer Jason Todd with the white streak in his hair. I kind of like that character aspect. I know something little, but I like it. Kind of losing my train of thought now. Anyway, right. I'm getting so off topic. I'm so sorry. It was a nice thing. It was. Calm down there, Rouge. Did I not just catch you stealing from the train station gift shop? It's almost all his versions have simple hair. Yeah. And I do like that they gave him the kind of, like, also added touch that, he's also a rather smart character. Like, he's not just, like, I don't know, as some people would say, a jock shell with a dork filling. I like that. Because, like, he likes to read, he's smart, as well as, like, being big old buff scary man. if that makes sense. yeah. I don't know. I relate to him. Bro, we were supposed... Oh, yeah. We have to find out... Time to get back to work, Chief. Yes, yes. It was a pen, Knucklehead. Also, hi to whoever joined. How are you doing today? It was a pen, Knucklehead. Who's gonna miss a teeny tiny pen? What cast of characters am I stuck with? Get a hold of yourself, Liza Lee. You're sweating through your uniform. I am? Hey, pal, can I get one of those chili dogs? I'm not surprised he's asking for a chili dog. Rightio, friend. Ugh, of course, sir. That sounds like I'm timid. I'm not timid. I'm actually rather interested. I'm down for this. Rightio, friend. Also, just quick side note as well. Flashpoint version of him is actually very interesting, the take they put on him, on Jason. Anyway, back on topic. Well, aren't you friendly? See? Friendliness is key. Customer services skills. Why can't I be normal for 1 second? We can speedrun this game. Just kill him. I don't think we're the ones who kill him. I'm pretty sure we're the ones who try to figure out who killed him. Sonic, wait until I announce everyone's roles to get food. Ha, sorry about that, birthday girl. Okay, so we're gonna have to see. I see they're all dressed up and I'm not 100% sure why, but we'll see eventually, I'm guessing. I'll be coming around to collect everyone's tickets. Please have them out and ready. You'll join me, Eliza Lee, won't you? Just click on whoever you'd like to talk. With him, we'll collect their ticket. Okay, got it. They dress in so... Really? Really? Soviets wear this kind of stuff? let's start this side. Actually, no, I feel like we should start with the birthday girl. Can I please get the birthday girl's ticket? I'm not saying that. Why, certainly. Mostly the conductor? I can see where you got that from. Thank you, miss, and thank you for choosing our fine train for your birthday festivities. Okay. I actually really like the character sprites. They're well made, well drawn. They're actually quite sweet. Well, the birthday discount certainly helped, I can imagine. Who doesn't love a good bargain? No, that is so true. And a murder mystery train sounds so exciting. It's right up my alley. Oh, so they're here for a murder mystery. So that explains the title, Who Murdered Sonic. Who doesn't love a good thrill? You see, I'm a girl who loves a good true crime podcast. Maybe we should leave her to have fun. Before we move along, for you, miss. Oh, okay. There's a robot arm. Is it his arm? Or that looks like a key. Oh, how fun. Thank you. Where do I use this? Yeah, they made expressions of them really well, nice and nicely done. Yeah, they did. Where do I use this? That unlocks any door in the train. Happy birthday. The birthday girl gets the key, birthday key. It's practically tradition. Really? There's a birthday key? Okay then.
Very useful. We'll use this wisely. Thank you. Okay, we might as well just stick with this group and then we'll move across. I like that Shadow's so far away, just like away from everyone else. I used to have a crush on Shadow when I was like a kid. And on Sonic, admittedly. But like, that's like old news. May I have your ticket, please? Thank you very much. On top of it, I see. A princess such as myself always must be punctual. The princess? Did she just say princess? So she is a princess. You don't mind me asking, where are you visiting from somewhere? Yeah, she seems to be the only cat I've seen. Edgy, damn. Okay, Sonic is understandable. I... myself back in the day. I mean, what? Oh my god, that's a mood. Actually, I do prefer Shadow over Sonic, admittedly, because I like the whole edgy aspects. I'm actually quite keen on that kind of thing. anyway. Nowadays, I kind of look at it and I'm like, what the heck? Then again, I have such a variety of tastes, like, to be fair. A separate dimension, actually. A separate what? Just here for Amy's birthday, then I'll hop back on to my dimension. I mean, the only good Shadow was in Adventures when his character was well-written. I mean, that's true. I liked him in... I have this PS3 game. I'm pretty sure it's PS3. PlayStation 3. Where it's actually his game, Shadow the Hedgehog. He's got guns and everything is so cool. I quite prefer the birthday cake from this world more than my own, so I admit it's a bit exciting. Yeah, you know of it? I also liked the Sonic game, the Werehog, I think, or Sonic, you know, where he's like a werehedgehog. Music was banging. It was. It so was. You don't say. Well, I hope you enjoy your stay, princess. Unleashed. All right. Should I bow? Do I bow before a princess? You're a fan from childhood? I liked the games. I wouldn't say I was like a diehard fan, but I definitely was a mild fan. What are you doing? Please get up. Why can I not win with this group? And we might as well go to Rouge. Well, hello, you two. What can I do for you? Good morning, ma'am. Can we please get your ticket? My, how forward. Let me fetch it for you. She has such, like, a modern outfit, to be fair. Like, she's got, like, one of those Cali girls outfits. Come back here if you need anything else, you hear? Wow, she's so polite. Very easy to talk to as well. Ma'am, I saw you sneak that $20 bill out of my pocket. Of course she's trying to pickpocket the train guy. The conductor, right? Not train guy. I'm so smart. I'm gonna have to ask kindly for that bag. Way too horny outfit though. She wore him all the time, I guess. Yeah, a lot of people had a crush on her because like she had like the one, the sweetheart line thingy. I don't know what's it called. Like I'm pretty sure it's like a sweetheart neckline or something like that. I don't know. I don't know that much about fashion or anything like that, but my friend does and I've heard her talk something about like that. But like a lot of people simp for her. I mean, for me personally, I don't really get it, but you know, I mean, I have weird tastes myself, so I mean, gonna have to kindly ask for that back. I was definitely one of them as a kid, bro. Anyway, no, that's fair enough. That's fair enough. I mean, I wouldn't judge anyone on their tastes. I love that she's just like, oh no, oh no, I've been caught out. Actually, her eye color is rather similar to mine. Think about it. Anyway. I love that everybody's just like waiting just silently. Oh, this was yours? Must have slipped out. Here you go. I may not actually be the best at judging character. I kind of want to just click ooh. Okay, I didn't know we could do that. Ooh, we could do that too. Let's start. Having green eyes, I'm jealous. Don't, honestly, don't be jealous.
having a lighter eye color like me puts you at higher risk of getting dry eye. And with the amount of time I spend staring at a screen, I do have dry eye and I have to take eye drops because of it. So, I mean, plus you stand out more. Ooh, okay. What's this sticking out of the napkin holder? I hate the idea of a ticket lost and alone like this. Yes, because the ticket fee is so sad. True, but they still look cool. I mean, you're not wrong. I mean, I've always hated my eyes. At least for you. Yeah, I mean, it's fair. Let's be sure to return this to its rightful owner. Okay, so we found a lost ticket, so somebody's losing a ticket. Let's make sure no one uses their ticket as a napkin. Lost ticket has been added to our inventory, so yes, we have a lost ticket with us. Steal it? Why would we steal it? We work here. We get on the train for free. Okay, Knuckles. Ooh, I like the purple eyes. The purple eyes is cool. Howdy, could I please- Aw, oh, damn it. I swore to myself I would never say this word. Could I please get your ticket? I think that's a ticket, so it's all crumpled up and everything. But I don't really want to argue with this guy. Everything looks good. Thank you. Seems the conductor doesn't want to argue either. I don't blame him. Knuckles is known for aggression, violence, hating on Sonic for, you know, flirting with his sister. And Tails? Can I get your ticket, youngin? There will be a Knuckles movie soon, I guess, or not soon. I don't know how to be honest. Actually, there might be a... Yeah, I'm pretty sure, like, in the Sonic... I don't know, maybe. I'd rather have a Shadow movie, to be honest, but like with featuring the others too. That would be quite cool. I mean, there's a teaser, really? I'll have to check that out after stream. Can I get your ticket, youngin? He's so tiny. I remember as a kid, I really liked Tails because he was one of the smart ones. And back then I really had like, I don't know, I wouldn't say an obsession, but I really favored these smarter characters. But yeah. Oh, hello, hi, how are you doing? I hope you're having a lovely day. Welcome to the stream. We're only just kind of, you know, like, in this game, an ability to fly. Yeah, I mean, sure, I mean, the aerodynamics is kind of impossible. It's like a honeybee. When you think about it, the fact that Tails can fly, in terms of body mass, compared to how fast his tails could propel, I don't think it would be physically possible, but, I mean, this is a cartoon game. Have a nice day. Yes, I hope you do have a nice day here. How's your day been going? Also, we are just kind of sort of into this game, so you haven't missed out on much, if you plan to stay. Right here, sir. I like that Tails is just polite. He's got that sweet vibe. I hope you will find a place in our regiment. I hope you find this to be a satisfactory and happy community that I hope you will want to stay in. Thank you. May I offer you any snacks we have on board? No, thank you. When I travel, I always pack my own sparkle gelatin. I'm guessing that's like actual gelatin, or it's a sparkly jelly that can melt any jaded heart. Huh. No way, I brought my own sparkle gelatin with me too. It's my first day and I was a little nervous. I feel like we'll have a friend in Tails. Don't be nervous, you're doing great so far. We're sparkle gelatin buddies. See, there's nothing to be nervous about. I mean, Tails is the least scariest person about. Absolutely. If you need anything, just let us know. See, that's the good customer service skills we need. Thank goodness someone on this train is normal. We might as well go to the main character himself, Sonic. Ticket, please? Thank you kindly. Happy to have someone as renowned as yourself on board. I love that we're just confused. Yes, confusion. Don't worry about it. I just like helping. When Eggman took over, I truly feared the worst. But my kids swore you would swoop in eventually. And you did.
Okay, I can't tell ages very well if that's not already evident, but like, he seems like his kids would be adults. But, you know, I don't know, man. I can't offer much other than my sincere gratitude. Hey, I was wondering why Sonic ain't dead yet. Have we derailed so long that... Yeah, I'm pretty sure that... this isn't a tutorial, but yeah, I'm pretty sure we did get so sidetracked before. But like, it's a good thing. Don't sweat it. I'm glad you and your family are safe. See, I think that's what kind of drew me to Sonic as a kid. I liked that he had that real bubbly personality that was also just really empathetic, but also he could have like a bit of a neener side, if you get what I mean. Wait, a second? Is he Sonic the Hedgehog? I don't know if y'all remember, but I was playing Gartic Phone with you guys. Oh, I do remember you! How are you doing? I actually do plan on having a Gartic Phone playing Gartic Phone again, and I also plan to play an Uno stream, sometime, if you're interested, like, you know, the Uno online, since I've never played Uno before, like, ever. So I was kind of wondering if you'd be interested in that sometime or something. And we're in the progress of setting up our official Discord server! But yeah, I just if you're interested. I promise. Also, hi to whoever joined. How are you doing today? I hope you're having a lovely day. Anyway, yeah, I'm getting really sidetracked. Anyway, I promise you an excellent stay on our train, Sonic. Have fun now. Stop advertising. Yeah, I'm sorry. Yes. Have fun now. Why is my character so like flinchy? Stop advertising when it ain't done. Yeah, well, at least people will be aware that it's certainly coming out soon. Will do, thanks. I have no clue who this is, actually. Can we please see your ticket? He doesn't seem too happy. Espio? Of course. Thank you. Excellent, thank you, and I hope you enjoy your stay with us. The volume, like, the music to, me speaking, that isn't, like, too, like, out of proportion, isn't too loud, isn't too quiet, right? It's, like, at the right, like, volume? Is it? I don't know, I can't really hear it myself, and I don't know, man. It's decent? Okay. Do I need to turn any volumes up or down? Or is it okay? Absolutely, I appreciate it. Okay, I don't know, something about that. I mean, you are pretty loud, so it works. Okay, that's good. Sorry. I think I got the mic really close. Not gonna lie, something about with the rose, his posture and everything, he kind of seems like, I don't know. How do I put it? Like, he seems like one of those flirty people. Not exactly sure what creature he is either, but you know, oh well. There's a calmness about him. Something about his presence puts me at ease. Really? Not me. It unsettles me. Are you consider me calming? He's looking right at me. Wait, can he read our minds? I study ninjutsu. I believe one can communicate through the subconscious. Wow, ninjutsu. That sounds a lot like a lot of difficult training. Can you cling to walls? Clinging to walls? What kind of question is that? No, that is a rather out of the blue question. Most certainly can. The conductor looks a bit smug at that answer. Who else? We have this guy and this guy. Conductor, hello my friend, can I get your ticket? Yeah, sure. Of course. He doesn't seem that something about that line just kind of seems a little sus. As a gentleman of an upstanding morals, I'd love to show you my ticket. He's stalling. You communicate by the subconscious while splitting their head in half. No, I like that. I like that. That is very funny. That is good. He seems to be avoiding eye contact. He's stalling. Is something amiss, sir? I think he's misplaced his ticket. Ah, I'm right. He misplaced his ticket. I was right. I seem to have misplaced my ticket.
I wish the Archie comics did something like that. That would be rather interesting. Rather dark and gruesome turn. Your favorite is Amy? She's very sweet. I like Amy. Her character design's cool. And I love her Pico Pico hammer. Could you please speak up a bit? I couldn't quite hear. I misplaced my ticket. I don't know where it is. She really is sweet. He's not hiding his embarrassment very well. No, evidently not. Actually, we may be able to help you. Leslie, why don't you show our friend what we picked up? And here is the lost ticket, so I'm guessing this is the one he lost. Ah, there it is! That's my ticket! Thanks so much, you two! I was really worried you'd kick me out and miss the murder mystery. Why are you apologizing? Nothing's wrong, it's alright. I'm kinda curious. I have a weird feeling he might be the one to kill Sonic. Wonder how long till we corrupt your mind. Oh my god. Is this a competition? Oh, Eliza Lee, what if their hands full kicking you out? No, I mean, kicking someone out of a train doesn't exactly sound that hard. You just open the door and go, kick! Never. Okay, I'm just gonna say this now. Never do that on a bullet train, please. That would be a terrible idea. Yeah, you're right. I wouldn't leave without a fight. They were both laughing. Wait, who made me microwave expert and security guard? You're both alright in my book. Thanks again for the assistance. Of course, just let us know if you need anything else. Okay, so now we just have Shadow.
I was about to say Sonic. Shadow, my favorite character. I like Shadow, he's cool.
I feel like it would be cool if they gave him purple eyes. That would be a rather interesting aspect. But the red still does work too because of the darker, like, fur color. Here. I love that you don't even have to ask. The croc is too dumb and kind for killing him. Ain't no way, I bet. On the purple cat, he's... The purple cat. Blaze. I'm surprised they didn't add Silver in. Wait, I thought Sonic was alive. Sonic is still alive at this moment. He's not dead yet. I'm not 100% sure how they kill him. Or his frog. What frog? There is no frog here. I'm so confused. He is. For now, that sounds so ominous. Thank you. Everything is in order. He seems concerned about something. Is there anything else we can help you with? Do you sell gift bags here? I have a feel- Okay, if he's asking for gift bags, I'm putting two and two- I'm just using my detective skills here. Putting two and two together. He's looking for a bag. It's Amy's birthday, so I'm guessing he hasn't gotten her a present yet, or hasn't given her a present yet. So he's looking for a bag? Maybe? Question mark? I'm not sure. Do you sell gift bags here? You wanna kill him? Oh, interesting. Interesting. Maybe chat is the murderers. No, sadly. But I have a plastic grocery bag in the back I could get for you.
I love that side eye. He's just like, bro, not helping.
Well, if it's gonna be either Tails or Amy. Ooh, that's an interesting assumption. I mean, Tails is analytical and has tech knowledge, so I mean, technically he could kill Sonic in a way if you're thinking this way. Brr, that cold stare. Liza Lee, you're shivering. Do you need me to fetch your jacket?
Okay, that's a very sweet thing for my boss to say, but no.
No, I'm good. Okay, everyone, time for me to read out everyone's roles for the murder mystery.
Or the streamer, I would never kill Sonic. I would roast him on a barbecue. Who knows? Yeah, I mean, maybe Sonic. No, I'm actually not gonna say that. Anyway,
okay, everyone, time for me to read out everybody's roles. And that's my cue to leave. I must prepare the driver's compartment for departure. Ah, the conductor's car. You remember our promise, yeah?
Yes.
The closest people are always the killers. Ooh, that is an interesting assumption, but not always. You'll do everything in your power to make sure our guests have a safe and enjoyable time on the Mirage Express? Absolutely! You can count on me and chat here with me, so we all will do our best. To be honest, this group seems plenty capable on their own. And the train? My bet is on the conductor. He is a mastermind who will use all of this as marketing to earn money. I don't trust his mustache. Oh man, I actually don't know anybody with a mustache. That's weird. Anyway, and the train? Assist Eliza Lee if they need any help, won't you? Okie dokie. Okay, so just silence? That's all I need to hear. You have my trust. Thank you for trusting me on the first day of my job. Nothing better than running a murder mystery. Nothing more heartwarming than a conductor and his train. Excellent, I'll be off. I love the height difference too. Obviously Tails, I'm not sure how old Tails is in this, but isn't his original age like, what, 9? And I'm not sure how old Sonic's depiction is. I must take my leave, everyone. Please, have a phenomenal time. And don't worry about mucking up the place either. This train's state-of-the-art and has systems for dealing with all that. For everything else, please talk to Eliza Lee here if you need anything. Sounds good! Absolutely. Will do. Okay. Oh, no, I love her sprite. It's so sweet. You can grow one out then, I believe, and you bro. First off, I'm a girl, so I mean, I don't exactly think I can grow a mustache, and number two, I don't necessarily want a mustache. Thank you. I like that guy. Thank you all for following the guide system I set out for you. You all look amazing. Oh, so she basically orchestrated this all and told them to dress up. So maybe you're right. Maybe you are right. Maybe Amy is the killer. What if Eggman kills Sonic at night? Ooh, that's another interesting idea. Maybe Eggman is secretly on board and ready to kill Sonic. Thank you all for following. I trust you all read your lore cards as well. Ooh, okay, that's well set out. She even made lore cards. That must be the details for the motivations. I suppose it makes sense. Lore cards aren't read out loud. Otherwise, people would know the murderer's intentions. Oh, so they already know who the murderer is, in a way, then. And you just called me a girl, bro. I'm sorry, man. Now, on to the nitty-gritty. For the murder mystery game, one of you will be murdered, and the rest suspects. Oh, okay, so it's only gonna be a fake murder. So Sonic isn't actually gonna die. Damn, that's a shame. I mean, what? Everyone has assigned roles for characters they will be playing. Participation is required, for it is my birthday, meaning her birthday, not mine. My birthday's already been. Of course. Birthday girl makes the rules. Sonic, you are a ship captain. Of course you would make Sonic ship captain. And you'll be stationed in the conductor's car. Naturally, that's where the captain would go. Tails, you are the detective. You'll be here in the dining car, so I'm guessing that will leave Tails off as the murderer, unless of course they're going the Bungo Stray Dogs route. Eggman will be too simple, and it's well made, so they will find a way to make it more interesting with someone else. No, I agree, maybe. Plus, we haven't seen Eggman on board, so I have a feeling, I'm kind of betting on the conductor in a way. You're the detective, you'll be here in the dining car, because think about it. Sonic is, bro, the title lied, it's a scam. It's not a scam, because here's my logic, here's my line of thinking. When you think about it, Sonic is the one who's going to die if the title of the game is right. So Sonic's in the conductor's car, the head car, and where's the conductor? Also in the head car, so that's my line of thinking. I'm thinking the conductor is going to be the murderer. What if it was him himself, meaning Sonic just died miraculously from his own hands? That's so dark. I like it. But I think it's the conductor. Tails, you are the detective. You'll be here in the dining car. No, don't apologize. No, I get what you're thinking. You know, undoubtedly. Indubitably. That's deep.
Knuckles, you're the sheriff. Okay, that makes the getup make more sense. You're the sheriff around these parts. We'll find you in the saloon.
Maybe possible. Yeah, I mean, we'll have to see.
Got it. Rouge, you're a business tycoon, and Blaze, you're a titan of industry, both in the casino.
Yeah, they both look like people you would see in a casino.
What's the difference?
There is none. It's just that they have different title names, which is fair.
Sounds fun. Interesting. Vector, you're the butcher. Okay, that makes sense. With, like, I was thinking maybe a blacksmith at first, but no, butcher sounds right. And Espio, the poet. He looks like he belongs in Shakespeare, so the fit does actually match up. Both found in the library. Why would a butcher be in a library? Hear that, Espio? We get to hang out together.
And do what? Read?
Maybe we can make a tower of books or something?
Shadow is a locksmith.
I mean, I've never met a locksmith, but I was kind of thinking with this kind of getup, maybe like the guy, a blacksmith. Are locksmith and blacksmith the same thing? I don't know. Hanging out in the lounge.
I feel like he'll be interesting to question. I feel like he'll just be like so straightforward and be like, bro, I don't care.
And last but not least, me, the journalist reporter. I'll be moseying around with everyone. Did you all get that?
Yep. If I said no, she'd probably get annoyed.
I was listening in. I hope that's okay. More than all right. You can help ensure everyone's following their roles.
Oh, that reminds me.
Oh, nice map. So, okay. So, I'm guessing we're here. So, the next place would be the salon?
Shadow is hot? Agree. Okay, I know this is gonna sound weird, but, like, yes. We were actually talking before about some of our childhood crushes on, like, some of these characters, and I definitely had a crush on Shadow as a kid. And still now, sort of. Like, at the same time, it's strange, but, like, it's yeah.
So the last two people we're going to interrogate is Shadow and Sonic. So we start off with Knuckles, go to Espio, then to this guy who I can't remember his name, then Rouge, then Blaze, then Shadow and Sonic. I have a map for each of you. Everyone's station is marked on this map as well. How convenient. Map added to my inventory. Okay, so we have the map here. The rules of the game are as follows. There is a murderer among you all.
It's among us. It's among us, but on a train.
The murderer can kill a single participant however they choose, but you must be physically be present with the victim for it to count. Everyone else must collect evidence through the train and use it to interrogate fellow passengers to figure out who done it. The murderer will lie to get out. Will lie to get out of being accused, so inspect everything you can. Find clues and interrogation.
Ooh, actually, that gave me a good video idea. Like, imagine doing that in real life, like something like this, like renting out like a big area and then doing it. That would be pretty cool. Oh my god, man. We having girl talk about those fancy animated lands. Oh my god, yes. Yes, slay queen. That sounds so weird saying.
I'll set a timer for 1 hour so everyone can mingle and the murderer can do their thing. Is everyone ready?
Sounds like everyone's excited.
Yes, I'm excited. I'm actually really hyped to see who the murderer is. Everyone to your stations.
My god, I've been live an hour? Jesus.
Ah, this is so exciting. A mystery is unfolding right under our very noses.
I know it's kind of scary. How thrilling, I have goosebumps. See, I would love something like this.
How thrilling, I have goosebumps. But costs, we leave that idea for later.
True.
Same. Isn't it awesome? Shouldn't you two be out there mingling with everyone? Well, actually, the detective and journalist can't be the murderer.
I'm going to go live, but I will still watch your live, but can't chat.
Okay, I hope you have a lovely live. If I finish the stream early, then I will definitely check out.
So, we're stuck here for an hour before going out and scoping the place. So, they're invincible, basically. This way, there's always a neutral party. Makes sense. Seems as though Amy's more excited about deciphering the mystery anyway. I don't blame her, that would be quite cool. We spent almost an hour to get out to the starting zone. I know, it's weird, man. It doesn't feel like this has taken an hour. What do you think everyone's doing? Oh, probably inspecting their stations and talking amongst one another. Everyone has... Yes, take care, and I hope you have a lovely stream. Everyone has their roles to play, so they must be exploring their character. Do you know what their character motivations are? No, the lore cards are confidential. No one knows but the person who received them. Okay, so my question is, who wrote the lore cards then? My backstory is that I was best friends with a Flicky, so I'm guessing that's a Flicky? Maybe? I'm not actually sure. That decided to join the evil Dr. Eggman, kickstarting my desire for justice in the world. So basically Batman. No, I'm kidding. His parents were murdered. My lore is that I'm a nosy person turned journalist. Okay, that is fair. That is very fair. Not gonna lie, this sounds kind of fun. It does. It does sound kind of fun. Wish I wasn't stuck on microwave duty. The train started moving. It's so fast. Grab onto something, maybe. Okay, well, when we think about it, only two people are in the conductor car, meaning Sonic and the conductor, meaning maybe one of them started the train? Sonic wanted to, Tails, man. What's going on? I'm slipping. Maybe Sonic wanted to start preemptively? So, basically... Okay, and darkness. Ooh, okay, interesting. You're both awake. Yeah, it seems the train has slowed down considerably. Wow, how exhilarating, or is everyone all right? I feel like in a situation like this, it's better to use concern rather than, this is gonna be great. They are really surprised that the train started moving. It's a train. Well, I mean, things have fallen down, so I mean... It seems we've been knocked into the dining car's closet. This train can reach such incredible speeds. Yeah, so it's basically like a bullet train. We're getting our money's worth with this experience, that's for sure. Is this actually intended? It's my first day, so I'm not really sure. I don't recall them warning me about this in the interview. We should go check on the others. Leslie, can you get the door? Of course. It seems the door is blocked, and I don't think it's budging. Ooh, okay, so we're trapped in here. Amy, give me that fallen shelf and whack it with your Pico Pico hammer. The title wasn't a scam. It's not a scam. Let's go. Let's see who murdered Sonic. Let's find another way out. I'll start looking for clues. I'll search over here. She's acting weird. She's sus. I know, Amy. She's hiding something. Okay, so Tails thinks she's hiding something. I do like that they added that little tilt of the ear. It does seem quite an interesting aspect. Huh? I suppose she did wake up before us. Something could have happened. Listen, I know I'm the detective here, but all the best detectives have sidekicks. I'm gonna need your help. Awesome, we're gonna help! Let's gather clues on why Amy's acting this way and interrogate her about it. Oh yeah, nothing better than interrogating your friends, man. Check out everything you can around this closet. Then we'll show it to Amy to uncover the full situation. Gather evidence and interrogate. You got it. Okay, let's gather some evidence and interrogate.
I need you to do everything in your power to make sure our paying guests are well taken care of. Understood? Okay, so we gotta take care of people. You can count on me, Tails. Yes, we can do this, right? I won't turn evil like your ex-flicky companion did. Happy to hear it. Now let's get searching. She looks so wobbly. I think because we're gonna interrogate her, we don't look at her first. Ah, the wet floor sign. Keeping people safe and alert. Once I slipped up on some spilled juice at the grocery store. No wet floor sign at all. So that is quite dangerous. Luckily, Sonic there was there to catch me. But he was going so fast, he also slipped on the juice. Yeah, I saw that coming. We slid into an old gentleman's shopping cart. Well, it's not that counts. Yeah, that's true. Shelf. The shelf is blocking our exit. It's currently not budging. Look closely at this. Okay, so there's like a chip broken. I wonder how the side of the shelf got smashed. Just break her legs? I mean, that's one quick way. That's one way to get answers. There's nothing the shelf could have fallen onto. She will talk later. There's nothing the shelf could have fallen into, and I'm sure this damage wasn't here before. The train has too much upkeep. Okay, so it's been broken on something. I feel like this is important. We should log it. Okay, crack on the shelf is added to our inventory. Okay. Well, there's our microwave. And there's a bin. Something's always hidden in the trash. Let's check there. Sadly, it's empty. Okay, so there's nothing in the trash. On the bright side, this is a very clean trash bin. How do I become as optimistic as this kid? What do you think, Tails? Want me to cook any of this for you? When we get out of here, sure. Normally, I never make microwave meals. I prefer to cook. Me too. My cast iron skillet has gotten a lot of use lately. I can cook a mean cast iron pizza. I've only had microwave lunches this week. So we check that. We check the shelf. Ooh, what's this? What's this? A rod? Maybe from a lever? The tip is broken. It looks to have originally been attached to something. Okay. The murder weapon! It's the murder weapon! I'm not sure if it's related to our mystery, but I like spinning it around. So, we'll keep it. Stick is added to our inventory. Yes. Think we found enough clues. Let's go interrogate Amy and find out what really happened. Okay. What's the latest? Find any clues yet? I found a spoon. If we find two more, we could dig ourselves out. I don't think that would work on a moving train. Dig ourselves out. On a train. I like that she seems so like, oh my god, oh no, he's seen through me. I'll keep looking. Interrogation. Amy, we believe you're hiding something from us. Yes, she is hiding something from us. What? You accuse me on my own birthday? Yes, I do. Damn, the lever looks like it was attached to something earlier. That's some great deduction. Yes, thank you. Obviously, I am, so smart. How dare you? This isn't going to be easy. I've been stuck in here, just like the two of you. What in the world do you think I'm hiding? Many things. Amy was awake before Tails and I were. What could she have been doing in that time? Murder a suspect? Quick, break her legs. We first do, then ask questions later. Microwave a chili dog? I doubt she'd do that. Murder a suspect, maybe? No, but she said she's invulnerable, so attempt to escape. I don't think you were sitting idly while Eliza Lee and I were knocked out. Your attempt to escape the closet. Prove it. Okay, we have to prove it. Show me evidence that I attempted to escape, or help me search for a way out. Ooh, the stick thing. She seemed reluctant about her hammer. She seemed reluctant about her hammer. So, technically, if you think about it, maybe it's from her hammer? But it looks more like a lever. Like a lever. Oh, it's a handle. So maybe I'm right. Maybe I'm right. Do we have evidence to prove that? Let me step you through this. First, find the correct piece of evidence from your inventory. Once that has been deduced, we must form our argument to fight back. Alright, let's do it! What proves Amy attempted to escape the dining car closet? This one. I'm not quite sure this will convince Amy. Let's give it another try. What evidence proves Amy attempted to leave the closet? Okay, so maybe that's not right. The only other piece of evidence we have is crack on the shelf. What? Some kind of damage on the shelf is supposed to prove something? It fell over. Damage makes sense. You have no argument here. You're grasping. I may be onto something? Yes, yes. See, I'm smart. Oof. Okay, Tails, now what? Well, now we follow this train of thought. Oh, ha ha ha. Such a funny joke. How does the crack on the shelf relate to Amy? So now I have to explain myself? Well, you see, Well... When I get stumped, I like to think. Well, obviously, you need to think to be able to say stuff. What would Sonic do? Sonic's a force to be reckoned with. He's always running forward, collecting rings, crushing bad nicks. He never loses. Like an endless runner game? I play a lot of those on my phone. Wait, I'm confused. Why are we thinking about Sonic? Just close your eyes and think, what would Sonic do, and find your argument. Alright, let's prove we're not grasping. Let's follow the train of thought and fire a comeback. Like Sonic would do. Whoa. Whoa. What? Huh? Wait, we're Sonic now? Wait, I'm so confused! What's happening? I'm guessing we have to- Okay, well, we have to collect rings. Okay then. I don't know what that was about. But okay. Sure, the shelf fell, but there's nothing around the shelf to fall onto. Okay, yeah. I have no clue, man. I am lost too. You're telling me, on a train this well kept, that the damage was here before we arrived? I believe someone is responsible for hitting the shelf. Ooh. You just said nothing was around for the shelf to fall into. I'm pretty sure you would say fall onto rather than into. The Sonic part's still pretty lit. Yeah, that is true. What was the shelf hit with then? Oh no, the only other piece of evidence we have is that, because we can't say that was hit by a menu or a train map. This one. What is that? A stick? You truly believe a stick could do this kind of damage? Oh, okay, we're doing this again? Interesting. I'm so confused. Why Sonic? We're playing Sonic, but you know. Which, sure. Okay, now we have an idea. You're right. A stick can't do this kind of damage to the shelf on its own. But if it's attached to something, it could, like, let's say... A hammer? I was right. Okay, cool. I was right. She was acting suspicious about her hammer. So, I mean... It makes sense, in a way. Right? This isn't a stick at all, is it? This is actually the handle to your Pico Pico hammer.
I was right.
You attempted. I have no clue. How does that help the main character solve a mystery? I have no clue, man. I think they're just trying to get out of this area. You attempted to hit the shelf out of the way, but you failed. The handle to your hammer snapped right off.
She's been caught. We ratted her out. Imagine if Sherlock Holmes played Tetris to solve Jack the Ripper case. Oh, that would be so funny. I would definitely watch a show like that.
It's as you both said. I tried to get us all out with my hammer, but I failed. I gave the shelf one big whack and the handle ripped right off. I figured it was no big deal and tried to hide it, but I suppose my embarrassment got the better of me.
Really?
She does look genuinely sorry about the situation.
Why would you hide it, though? I mean, you tried to escape. That's a normal thing.
I never expected your hammer to snap like that. It was one of my backups. It's a lighter to carry around. I didn't think I'd need it. Okay, that's fair enough. Well, lucky for you, I'm a detective and I dabble in as a mechanic. Let me see. Both pieces of the hammer. Just tied things here, a little elbow grease there, and fixed.
How did he fix a snapped off hammer? Did he like have duct tape or something with him?
According to my calculations, if you hit the shelf right here, it should do the trick.
So destruction of private property. That's great, man.
The shelf completely shattered because that's how shelves work apparently now.
I have a shelf. And I doubt if I just hit it with once with a hammer, it would break.
It's a really sturdy case. I can deduct
that it was from IKEA.
We did it! We're free! Okay, cool, we're free. Great job, Amy. Let's get out of here. I'm pretty sure shelf is spelled... I don't know. Wait, is that...
Oh, we finally see Dead Sonic. Finally. Yay, he's dead.
My brain dies and rots. Yes, this is actually kind of confusing.
It can't be. I love that just like all the light has left his eyes. Sonic, Tails XE has stopped working.
Sonic! Oh no! Someone murdered my darling Sonic!
See, that's my face to, when it comes to, like, murders.
Yay! Interesting. Let's figure out who murdered this. Looks like the game's begun. I'm finding out who did this at once. Amy, wait! I want to figure out who did this too. So it's Sonic who's dead. What a whirlwind. I'm exhausted already.
Already? Bro, we only just started. Sort of.
That was really convincing, Sonic.
Oh, interesting. Maybe he's actually dead. Sonic?
Eh.
Body, numb, can't move. He's talking, so he's still alive. Finally, he's dead, yes.
What are you saying? I don't understand. Just need to rest. Sonic? Sonic? Is he actually hurt?
At least we're concerned and, like, genuinely, like, worried.
He's not moving. Are these wounds on him genuine? My hand's on his wrist, but I don't sense a pulse.
Oh. Oh, he is dead. There's no pulse. He is dead.
Am I doing this right?
What in the world's going on?
Is this part of the murder mystery, or is this serious?
Just throw him out the window. No one will know the difference.
Sonic!
Oh no, I feel my self-panicking. Calm down, Elizalee. What do I do? We yeet the body. Nobody can accuse us of murder.
I'm satisfied. Looks like the game's begun. I need you to do everything in your power to make sure our paying guests are well taken care of, understood?
I think it's this guy who killed him.
I mean, he was the only other person who was, like, in the same room as Sonic and could have, like, just carried him out and yeeted him out here.
These guests are incredibly renowned, which means they must be remarkably rich. Ooh, meaning he's trying to steal their wealth! So I leave their care to you, Liza Lee, my favorite employee. Surely you won't let me down for this one last ride. My favorite employee, I'm the only employee, apparently. Plus, this is my first day on the job. He seems like he would rob them. Oh no, he looks like he would rob them. I need to catch up to Amy and Tails to get to the bottom of this. Even if this is part of the game, I just can't risk it. I'll keep everyone safe, Conductor. You'll see. Oh, so the game's like only just begun. Oh, interesting. The murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. Yay! We make him go bye-bye. Saloon car. Saloon car? Saloon car. Whoa, look at this place. Amy, are you here? I feel like we should look for Tails because I trust Tails a little more than Amy at this point. Plus, Tails is analytical and a detective, so I mean... Wait, let me just quickly look at the train map. So if we're in the saloon, yeah, we're here with Knuckles. Tails. Liza Lee, I'm over here. I think Amy's already gone ahead. She seems really excited. Did you need something from me? Just a question, really. Okay, I'm sorry for leaving, but I really want to sleep and need to. Sorry for the typos. I'm ahead to bed. If the conductor ain't the killer, then I'm a sub, so you better find out. Take care, Feely, and I'll inform you on the local stuff later. Okay, thank you so much, and I hope you have a lovely sleep, and I appreciate you joining stream. And please, please do take care of yourself. And I hope you have a lovely day when you get up. And again, thank you so much for everything you've done for me. It's honestly such a help, and I honestly appreciate everything so much. Bye-bye, have fun. Thank you, I will, and I will inform you who the killer is. And yeah, again, please take care of yourself and have a lovely sleep. What if Sonic is actually hurt? He's laughing? Sonic doesn't go down so easily. He's on a train full of his friends. Nothing would actually happen to him. We're just all really committed to the murder mystery for Amy. You have nothing to worry about. Promise. Plus, Sonic likes to nap in a lot of strange spots. He's fine. I like that he's so easy to dismiss. Oh, wanted. That little guy's wanted. He's making a lot of sense, but I can't shake what Sonic said to me. Is this really part of the mystery game? Murder mystery game? Or is there something deeper happening? I need more evidence to figure out what's going on. Can I tag along with you? It's my job to keep an eye on you. Can I tag along with you? I'll ask to tag along. If you don't mind, is it cool if I tag along with you? Well, of course, sure. Now, if I ever need a snack, you've got me. Wait, is he just... Am I wrong in assuming that he's referring to himself as a snack? You know what? We're gonna bypass that. As you said, the best detectives have sidekicks, so I'm happy to have you. If you ever catch me looking glum, though, just know it's because, where's my lore card? The last guy to work on a case with me ditched our practice to join the evil Dr. Eggman. Well, I'm not gonna lie, I do like this kind of sprite. This sprite, it actually is quite cute. Not a proper detective without baggage. That's true. Ya varmints. I'm not doing the accent since I am from Texas. What are y'all doing in my saloon? He's trying so hard to stay in character. That is actually quite sweet. Knuckles! We're trying to figure out who murdered Sonic. I can see that. Amy Mosley threw and told me all about it. Enough of that. Yep, please don't make me do that. Wonder how long he kept that voice up for Amy.
We were wondering if you could tell us what you were doing up before the murder. Anything to help us establish your alibi, and... Nope, I have nothing to tell either of you. Leave me alone. Oh, he's suspicious, and there's things broken. Oh, that's broken. He was playing video games and he got mad and he broke it. He punched it. Yep, that's my deduction. He's obviously agitated about something, but why take it out on us? I know better than to argue with Knuckles, so it seems we're on our own. We need to figure out what Knuckles was up to while we were apart. Let's investigate for clues and then interrogate. Alright, let's do it. He's leaning on it, so I'm guessing he broke the machine. Clearly, we won't be able to give the game Super Monkey Ball a try. Do we think it broke when the train sped up? The damages look more to be caused from punches. I was right. He rage quitted. Because that does seem like something that Knuckles would do, to be fair. I mean, he is a rather aggressive character. Who could have done that? Who else but Knuckles himself? What are you two looking at me for? You're the only one in this room. Smash Arcade is added to your inventory. You already can tell, we have enough evidence. But I told you to leave me alone. Please don't beat me up. I like your hat. No, that sounds rude. I like your hat. Oh my god, man. I like the feistier characters. But like the tsundere vibe, like the blush. Are you blushing? I love that Tails is pulling him up. I said leave me alone. You're avoiding the question, man. It doesn't look like he's used to being complimented. Aw, that's actually kind of sad. Well, that's mood then again. Did you just adjust your hat a bit so we could see it better? I said leave, he's angry. Can I take your order? Let's try be nice. Not hungry. Well, if you ever are, just let me know. You'll let me know, won't you? Sure, like a butler of sorts, right? Well, I mean, it's good customer service. Come on, Eliza Lee, you're not a butler. Tell him that. Yeah, like a butler. Yep, contradicting myself. That's great, man. Excellent. Thank you, butler. I'm not your butler. Dang it. Anyway, let's start the interrogation. I don't think we have enough evidence yet. Why don't we look around a little bit more first? Okay. Bowl of nuts, the classic saloon snack. Kinda bland. Seems like someone licked all the salt off them. Oh, that's gross. Or maybe they're just unsalted. I like that she said that instead. Drinks. This is interesting. So basically he's been snacking, drinking, and then smashing. That doesn't sound right. A few cups. Sure, but why are there three? Knuckles was really thirsty? Wesley, this one has lipstick on the rim. So Rouge and maybe Blaze then came over? That's not Knuckles' color at all. So we're implying that it's not his color. Not that he would not be wearing lipstick. No, it's just not his color. Someone must have been here. We should log this. Used cups are added to your inventory. I think we found enough clues. Let's interrogate Knuckles and find out what really happened. Or it could be like the arms, but then again the conductors would like run that. Let's start our interrogation then. Knuckles, Eliza Lee, and I have determined what you were doing during the hour the murder took place. I already told you, buzz off. You're not getting anything out of me. I'm sure we can get something out of you. Thankfully, we don't need you to say much. What happened here is pretty obvious. Is it? Yeah, it's pretty obvious. He got mad, broke the machine, and it's a two-player game. From what I can see, there was lipstick on the cups, meaning, and three cups so you can tell it was someone else, and there were snacks, meaning somebody was snacking and hanging out with Knuckles, and therefore they were playing a game with him, and maybe they bet him a lot or whatever, and he got mad and broke the game. Done. We have evidence, too. Yep, we do. Leslie, just take a good look at her inventory. That was distracting Knuckles during the time Sonic was murdered. What was distracting Knuckles by the time Sonic was murdered? The game. Arcade machine? Ha! What makes you think I touched it? Think? It's broken. I wouldn't be surprised.
Oops.
Let's try it again. Let's try it again. I can do better than that. Okay, I have enough rings. Let's go. This isn't a tough one, Knuckles. Knuckles, you clearly touched the arcade machine because Super Monkey Ball is your favorite game. How am I supposed to know that? I'm not close to him. Your hair was found at the scene. The arcade cabinet is covered in punches. I feel like that would be rude as an assumption to just say, because like you don't want him to think, oh my god, people know I have anger issues. Well, like at the same time, it is a little clear. Your hair was found at the scene. Super Monkey Ball is your favorite game. Let's just say this. While Super Monkey Ball has adrenaline pumping monkey ball action, this proves nothing about the current situation. May have been off the market. Let me try it again. Your hair was found at your scene. Hair? You mean fur? Fur? You mean spines? Alright, he's an echidna. Doesn't matter, because it seems I'm wrong here. Damn it! I guess I have to go the root option. I didn't want to say that because I wanted to go every other option because it's not accusing someone of their blatant anger, and I don't like that. It's confrontation. What evidence do you have that the punch damages are punches? What are you all standing at my hands for? Staring at my hands for? Knuckles, you clearly destroyed the arcade machine, but why? I needed a punching bag and none were available to me. Just a sudden urge to punch, huh? Maybe it's because you were losing a game, huh? I believe repairing the arcade machine will give us our answer. How will you? I mean, it is Tails. He is literally like a mechanic, so I mean. Distract Knuckles while I fix Super Monkey Ball. Bring it on. I have to distract him? Oh no. Oh no. Well, I mean, he's shy, so I mean, I have that option. This is actually really cool. Damn it! I was so close. Damn it, it was so close. I'll give it another try. Okay, I only need to get to 30. Bonus ones don't really matter, so I just need to make sure I get enough. I haven't played Sonic in so long. Oh my god, I keep not jumping. Okay, I can do it. I can do it this time. I can do it this time. I'm not this dumb. I swear. I swear I'm not this dumb. Okay, we got 38 rings. Let's go. And we have an idea. The arcade machine is fixed. What did we distract him with, though? No, don't look at the scores. Quick, look at the scores. I'm pulling it up now. Vector, Knuckles, Toast, Apple, Bread, Ultim, Bagel, and Candy. So, Vector, so I'm guessing, oh, Vector. As in the crocodile guy, and I'm guessing with the red lipstick on the cup, that might have been Rouge? Since, like, she does wear lipstick? Okay, what did this tell us? Nothing, obviously. It tells us something massive. Look at the name on the top of the list. Oh, and he only bet him by one. It's Vector, he's supposed to be in the library car. I love just, like, he's, like, lost of all- devoid of all souls and everything. The picture is beginning to be painted here. You competed with Vector to see who could get the highest score. And Vector beat you by 1 point. Oh, I feel bad for having to call him out. And in frustration, you destroyed the arcade cabinet. He's punching the air in frustration. You're guessing. What's your proof? Where's your evidence? Vector is a common name. Proof to be he was here now. Snacking, I guess, would be an evidence. Oh, I was too off. Okay, I need to try it again. Okay, let's do this. We can do this. I'm actually so terrible at this right now. Okay, there we go. 38. Something about the snacks will help. Now, Leslie, what proves Vector was here with Knuckles? Okay. So this one, the cops. No? I thought it was strange that there was more than one cop sitting next to you. Well, you were supposed to be participating in a murder mystery game for Amy's birthday. You and Vector enjoyed some drinks playing arcade. He's stumbling on his words. Don't tell Amy. I think we're on the right track here. Yes, we are. It's as you say, Vector popped in at the top of the hour wanting to play the arcade machine with me. We went back and forth trying to figure the game out, but when we did, we competed for the highest score. When he bested me, I destroyed the machine. No proof of his win. I was trying to fix the arcade cabinet before you two came in. Honest. I didn't want to be caught, which is fair. That's my story and alibi. I have already told an abridged version of this to Amy. Boy, this friend group sure has a lot of pride issues. That is true, buddy. Well, that explains one of the used cups. But what about the cup with the lipstick mark? It was Rouge. I thought so. It's inconsequential, not worth mentioning. She searched around for something, but failed, made fun of our game, and left. Obnoxious, that one. But you offered her a drink, apparently. Listen, I don't know why she showed up, and I've told you everything that happened before the train sped up. Still, I don't think that Rouge would have murdered Sonic. I'm understanding the scenario. Vector visited to play games, Rouge couldn't find something and left, then Knuckles destroyed the machine. That all makes sense to me. Thank you for answering so many of our questions. Actually, that's not everything, is it, Knuckles? Ooh, what else is there? I want to step back to something I noticed. One more name on that high score list doesn't make sense. Can you take a look one more time? Really? Vector, Knuckles, Toast, Apple, Bread, Ultim. Oh, Ultim. All the other names have food themes, but this one. I never actually noticed that before. Tails is smart. Who goes by Ultim? You may not know. But, no, Elizalee, but there's someone that goes by the name. The Ultim life form. Oh, ultimate life form. Shadow? Yeah, I thought so. There's really someone that goes by that? I'm not surprised Shadow would go by that. Nothing sneaks by you, does it, bud? Vector and I were struggling so much with the game, but then Shadow dropped by. So Shadow was here too, okay. He taught us the game and was the first to get his name on the scoreboard. Vector and I then fought to beat Shadow's score. They're both very annoying. You all immediately had to compete, huh? He gave me this before he left. Ooh, a key. Shadow told me to lock the door and not to open it for anyone. Then he left. Okay, that's not suspicious at all. When Vector was leaving, I locked the door behind him. No one saw no one else after locking the door. That's the honest truth, but then how did Sonic? So when Amy came through here not too long ago, did you open the door for her? No, I think she had some sort of key. Okay, so the birthday key. Well, I have a lot of questions. Like, how did Sonic get out?
What happened in the library to cause Vector to come here? Why shadow locking doors? And what was Rouge searching for? Oh my god, there are so many questions, it's hurting my brain. I don't know, they didn't tell me. Even though I asked with that cowboy accent. Number one, it's not a cowboy accent, it's a southerner accent. There's a difference. You're gonna have to find them and ask them yourselves. Okay. More information than I expected to get there. But it seems we can move on. As of right now, I believe your story, Knuckles. We'll only know for sure when we can confirm things with Vector. Fair enough. The library's in the next car. I'll open the lock for you. Give whoever KO'd Sonic an earful for me. Detective Tails and Butler. I'm not a butler, and how did he know Sonic is KO'd? I liked it better when he wasn't talking to us. Aww. Will do, Sheriff. Come on, Eliza Lee. Let's head over to the library. This way, more exciting than microwaving chili dogs. Oh my god, not all cowboys say that. That is so annoying. Nobody cares about the arm. Ready to mosey down to the next car? You got it, partner. I hate the stereotypes. The stereotypes are so mean. So horrible. Not everybody from Dallas or anybody around there talks like that. Nice library. Look at him. I still think it's a conductor who murdered Sonic. All this stuff's getting heavy. I'll dump what I don't need. Everyone's favorite journalist reporter, Amy Rose, is hot on the scoop. I'm heading out. You've been fabulously helpful. Already? Before you go, Espio and I wanted to give you your presents. Aw, that's sweet. Of course she immediately turns around. Aw, you're both so sweet. Thank you. Vector, it seems we have more guests. Kimmy, there you are. Want us to join you finding clues? Have you found any leads yet? Ooh, the detective pair needs help from the birthday girl. She knows everyone's allowed to be sassy on their birthday. The tip is just too juicy to ignore. I'll see you all around. Don't worry, Sonic. I'll be the one to avenge you and quick. Okay, so she's basically just gonna leave anyway. But how are you gonna leave? The door to the next car is locked. Oh, you doubt the birthday girl? She has the birthday key. The birthday girl has a master key. True. Right, the birthday girl gets the birthday key, so she can go anywhere she wants in a way. Of course, it's a birthday privilege. I'll solve this case before anyone else. I don't think she'll solve the case before any of us, but, you know, might as well let her try. She can try. Amy may be hasty, but she's thorough. Now, what are you two doing? Looking mighty suspicious, I say.
Ugh, jeez, I hate sneezing.
I'm the detective. I can't be the murderer. And I'm, just making sure. Here to ask if anyone's hungry. I'm starved. I'd kill for a chicken parmesan about right now. He'd kill Sonic? Maybe kill isn't the right language to use right now. I'm Vector, the butcher. I'm licensed to handle raw meat. Okay, that's... You know what, we're gonna move past that. And I'm Espio, the poet. He does seem like a poet. He looks like he's into Shakespeare. Ah, poetry. A resonant message from poet to reader meant to challenge our delicate perspectives with the most rhythmic of prose. Can I hear some? I love how shocked he's like so just caught off guard by that. Sure, Teardrops in the spring, can you hear me sing la 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 dee 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 dee? Nice try, buddy. Was that it? I have more if you like. Tree blossoms in the spring. he's going the same way. I'm satisfied for now. Thanks. At least he's rhyming, I suppose. Eliza Lee and I are here to establish both of your alibis. Can you two walk us through what happened after Amy had everyone leaving the dining car?
Oh, sure. It's simple. We just explained this to Amy, actually.
When we were all sent off, Rouge, Blaze, Shadow, and Sonic all passed through this library car. Okay, oh right, because they're supposed to mingle. So they all moved from here to like here, and then they moved through. So what happened to Rouge, Blaze, and Blaze? What were they doing? Because we saw Shadow. I'm curious what he was doing. He's in like a piano room.
Where Amy told me and Espio to stay. I probably picked a book off the shelf and made myself comfortable.
Okay, that I can believe. He does seem like the type who would just, like, read.
Factor got bored, so we left to see what Knuckles was doing.
Okay. Where was Rouge? What happened?
We happened to see her lipstick stain a cup in the saloon car.
Rouge came...
Wait. Oh yeah, Rouge isn't there on the map anymore, which is strange.
Rouge came over to the library car, seemingly looking for something.
Okay, there she is. So, I'm guessing she was trying to rob people.
Then she went to search the saloon car, trying to rob people.
She came back shortly after. We all heard her shout, "No way," at the brochure stand over there. But she left back to the casino car before Shadow came through and locked the door.
Okay, then. Wonder what she found. She's obviously being on the hunt for something.
After Rouge left, Shadow walked through the casino car. Maybe she's trying to look for a present for Shadow?
Because maybe that's why he was asking for a bag earlier on. So he can get something for Amy if he forgot, maybe?
I'm not 100% sure, I'm just guessing. Then entered the library car and locked the door behind him. More importantly, why has Shadow been locking doors?
Shadow walked through the library car to the saloon car where Knuckles and I were playing games. He insisted on showing us up at Super Monkey Ball. Got so engrossed by the rolling monkey action, I hardly noticed that Shadow left the saloon car. I guess he walked through the library and casino car again, locking doors behind him. So I'm not 100% sure, other than my guess of maybe he forgot a gift for Amy and he's looking for something, or like a bag to put it in. Otherwise, I'm not 100% sure what Shadow is doing, and I don't exactly have any guesses.
He then returned to the lounge car where he was meant to be stationed.
So how did they know that, though? That he kind of, like, left there? Can they see through walls?
Then When Vector came back, we realized Knuckles locked the door to the saloon car. We were stuck in the library car.
And that's when the train sped up. We were worried about the bookshelves falling on us, but we got through it all right.
We sat trapped until Amy arrived asking questions. She's the one that told us someone murdered Sonic.
And yeah, that's all happened.
No, I think their alibi is quite normal, actually. With all of these locked doors, it seems Vector and Espio couldn't have left the library car or the saloon.
Thank you for both of your cooperation. We're going to peek around and we'll return with any questions.
If you return with any meat, I'll just chop it up for you.
Okay, does Sonic count? We'll just drag him back.
Have Porcupine?
For dinner.
If you'd like to be serenaded with a poem, I got you covered too.
Thanks, guys. Okay. So, like, we see an arm in, like, every place, and that's only because it's normal, though, so I'm not sure.
Their alibi seems solid enough, but we should still search for clues.
We should look for any evidence that proves what they're saying is true. Need to confirm Vector's reason for leaving his post and determine if Espio is actually in the library car reading.
Oh, true. So, like, we have to make sure he didn't, like, leave or anything.
A small task, but we can do it.
Let's get to the bottom of this, Tails.
Absolutely. Okay, so he's just humming, so we'll leave him alone. He's writing poetry. Let's start. Okay, that's skewed.
Oh, okay, something about this book. What's this bright red book?
Oh, yuck, this reeks of evil scientist Dr. Eggman.
Yeah, this is Dr. Eggman's autobiography and recipe book.
What kind of recipes? Who cares? I wouldn't trust any book he's written. It's weird that this is even here.
Okay, so maybe that's something?
Maybe people just appreciate an omelet?
You may not be wrong.
Not 100% sure on that.
Okay, there's a globe. I'm not sure why the globe would be of any interest. A bin and books on the floor. So let's just start. Oh, I wish I could stop and look at all these books. Me too. I love reading. Sonic needs me. No time to rest. All right, let's move on then. Well, I mean, a little peek couldn't hurt. He's scavenging through all the book titles excitedly. He's like a kid in a candy shop, or in this case, a genius in a train library. Ooh, okay, so he's found something. That's odd. I know some books have fallen out on the floor and everything, but every book on this shelves are alphabetically ordered, but this one. The Mirage Express Manual. It's a user guide to the Mirage Express, the train we're currently on. Ooh, and there are arms and everything, so maybe someone hacked the system? Question mark? I'm not 100% sure, but we'll see. You think someone found it on the ground and put it back? Maybe, but it's interesting. Let's make a note of this. Okay. The glove of a marvelous planet. I haven't traveled around much. The islands are fun and all, but I'd love to visit some of the countries. They're a lot of fun, honestly. Plenty of wonderful people and shops. Their food can't be beat either. So I don't think that will be of any help. Sounds perfect vacation. The conductor was talking about Spagonia, if you've ever been there. I have, actually. If you're ever visiting, be sure to stop at the university and say hi to Professor Pickle. He'll tell you everything about the area and make one scrumptious sandwich. This group knows everyone and it's been everywhere, haven't they? Okay, let's look at- ooh, a table. Let's look at this bin. Something's always hidden in the trash, let's check there. I hate to say it, but there's nothing here, so none of the bins. Are you sad there was nothing in the trash bin? Kinda. You really think so? You're pretty unconventional, but I like that. Is that supposed to be a compliment? Let's look at the table next. Ah, let's take a pause and sit for a second. These chairs are comfy, so plush. Puts me right in the mood to read. Makes me want to take a nap, personally. In fact, maybe I'll rest my eyes a bit. So, if I had a ring for every time a murder ruined my nap time. Okay, so the table is nothing of use. Okay, let's see these books. So many books on the ground. Wish we had time to pick them all up. So maybe something's gonna be of interest? Sadly, I have no interest in picking up these books. A lot of these were knocked out by the train speeding up. But Rouge pulled a lot of these out for searching, too. What reckless behavior. I feel sorry for the poor books. I'm curious what she's looking for. These spines are creasing. They're opening too far. This kid feels empathy for everything. No, I agree with that, actually. Like, I like keeping my book. Like, I have quite a few hardcover books, but, like, I like keeping the spines nice. Okay, Chow? Hangs precariously from a tree. The large tags hang in there, like the kitten. Well, I really needed to see this. All the light has left his eyes. He looks traumatized. This little Chow's hanging there, refusing to use his wings to fly to safety because choosing the hard way is often the most rewarding. That's beautiful. If this Chow can stick to his principles and find strength, then I can too. There's no way there was that much thought put into the poster, right? Brochures. For travel destination areas like amusement parks, cabins, hotels, restaurants. Look at this, there are a couple maps here. Seems to be a map of the library guard. The books are categorized by genre where listings are. Okay. Should we take this brochure about a cave too? Look, there's statolites. Nobody shares my fondness of caves. No, I like caves, they're cool. I feel like we should question this guy before we go to this. To him. Shadow supposedly walked through the library car before going into the saloon car. When Shadow left the library car, he locked this door on the way out. There's got to be a good reason he's doing this, we should make a note of it. It's unlocked, currently. But that's probably because of Amy. Yeah, I do believe we should. A
Inspector and SBO and see what happened. Well, let's interrogate this guy first. Did you bring me any meat to chop? Unless you count Sonic's corpse? No, sorry. I may be a butcher, but they confiscated my meat cleaver before getting on the train. Had you tried to bring a knife on the train? I would too! No, I wouldn't, I swear I'm a good person. I'm a man of authenticity, Tails. Without a knife, I'm just a chef in a ketchup-stained apron, not a butcher. I think if you had a knife on you, we'd definitely think you were a murderer. What if I hid the knife? I mean, there is that option, sure. You know, I'm not the biggest fan of this line of thought. Can I take your order? Oh yes, please, I'm starved. Actually, I'm off duty at the moment, the murder mystery is more important. And why would you show the menu to me? I don't know. You thought I could trust you, made a fool of me. Made him a fool, oh no. No, I'm the fool. Okay, sure. Let's just talk with him. Let's start an interrogation. But I wouldn't be a proper detective without examining the volatility. Why, Vector left to go play games with Knuckles and SBO was really reading the library. We'll start with you. Why did you leave the library card to visit Knuckles? We are prepared to present evidence if need.
I got bored. That's a mood.
What? I wasn't entertaining him enough. It seems Vector enjoys being social. That's fair. Plus, we were instructed to mingle. I remember the arcade machine in the saloon car, so I figured I'd go check it out. Okay, that does seem to line up, I guess. Then what brings our attention to you is you, SPO. Rouge entered the library car, found something, then left. True. What did she find? You said you immediately started reading, but what were you actually reading the entire time you were in the library car? So, two things were out of place, the manual and the Eggman book. So, one of those maybe? Of course he was. Once SBO starts reading, he doesn't stop till it's done. I've seen it happen. It must have been a really good read. What was the book? The Eggman book, it's gotta be. If he's reluctant. He doesn't know you that, detective. Let the man live. What if it was embarrassing? What kind of things do you think I read? I feel like that was trying to imply something else, a little R34. You won't talk, I have a hunch on what the book might be. Leslie, could you help me out? Okay, well, we only have one book. The Mirage Express Manual. Manual? You think he was reading instructions? What argument could you possibly have support this? Actually, I believe it was the Eggman book, but you know. Oh shoot, the numbers went up on how many we have to collect. Okay, this is harder than it looks. We can do this, we got this, we'll try again. Oh my god, why am I so bad at this? So close. Jumping. I can do this. Why is my reaction timing so slow? I can do this. Mm-hmm.
dough. We didn't get enough. Okay, well, we'll have to just keep on trying. This is a rather interesting concept, though. Not enough. Okay.
Oh no.
Oh, okay. The left key. My keyboard just came off. Oopsies. Had to press that back in. Let's try this again. Okay, we have enough. We just can't lose anymore. And there we go. We got 49. Awesome. Now we have an idea. These books are scattered around the floor, but the remaining books on the shelves were all in alphabetical order. All except this manual, meaning someone, at the very least, picked the manual up and put it back in the incorrect place. I like that he's like, oh no. This lack of attention to detail isn't normally like you, SPO. Hey now, I won't have you insulting my pal like that. Aw, that's friendship. Butcher and a poet, friendship can form anywhere. Yes, it really can. That is indeed the book I was reading, the Mirage Express Manual. Trains are cool. I mean, that's a fair assumption. In that case, we'd like to ask you a few questions about the manual, Eliza Lee, if you don't mind. Could you ask SBO some questions about the manual? Just flip through a page and ask away. Oh, okay. Let's quiz him on 362. what efficient and extremely accurate technology was installed to assist in keeping the train spotless? Oh, that's obvious. The robotic arms. Even I know that. I mean, the arms are everywhere. During events, they can perform a variety of tasks and are responsible for cleaning up. Okay. I mean, that's quite an obvious one. Robotic arms can also detect weapons or explosives being brought into the train, ensuring passenger safety. Then why didn't they take away Amy's Pico Pico hammer? Seems like SBO aced that question. Hit him with another. Let's choose page 89. I feel like it's gonna be page 15. What is the cancellation policy? No refunds, and you will be charged a no-show fee. This does not apply if you're aged over 65. The person who made this rule must have been over 65. Last one. 56. What was implemented to support the conductor's duties and ease general train obligations? An intelligent data processing system and works in tandem with the conductor to ensure smooth travel for guests. Remember this, the train is autopilot. But it can't access its full suite of capabilities without the conductor present. Now, did I pass your little test? No. I hate to say it, but no. Just goofing, you passed. I completed your test with ease. All my efforts were only to please. But you joked and japed, said no to my face. Now I wish you were riddled with fleas. Oh, please, please no. Did he just rhyme a curse at me? Clearly you read the manual. Those answers feel far too specific for guesses. And you both had the nerve to question my buddy like that. What about the Dr. Eggman book? We don't want to be supporting folks who read. Don't we want to be supporting folks who read? You have to admit though, reading the entire time a murder occurred does sound a bit suspicious, even if true. But he answered all my questions so calmly, that's very impressive. Wait, but the mind reading thingy from before. Oh no, I understand everyone's cautious attitudes. Vector was the only one to see me reading after all. My alibi is hard to substantiate, despite being the truth. Well, he definitely read through the manual, so
I suppose we can't wait, but Rouge would have seen him reading. Vector was the only one to see reading, and Shadow also went through here. So technically, yes, that is correct. Problem? Frankly, I don't believe that can be true, and we have evidence to back it up. Leslie, you were supposed to be on the spot, yeah. Shadow. Shadow's lock? Please pray tell what this has to do with anything. We're up. Okay, well, obviously Shadow was in here, so therefore wouldn't he have noticed if he was reading the whole time, as he states? Wouldn't Shadow have noticed this? Because Shadow is very attentive to details, I'm pretty sure. At least you'd think he is. Damn it! Doll, okay. Not enough rings. Consider my time wasted, that's a mood. That's funny. He seems very well put together, if I'm honest. Doll, I keep getting hit. Doll, oh my god, I keep running into it. I'm not gonna make it. Oh, and it was two off. Okay, I can do this next time. I can do it. I can do it. I don't know. I think his character is starting to grow on me, Espio. Oh no, I kind of like the sassy attitude he has. Him and Shadow, I like both their characters. Okay, we got two more than we needed, which is great. So we made it through. Shadow walked through the library car to get to the saloon car, where he set the original high score in the arcade machine. Yeah, but I ended up beating it. It wasn't the high score long. Crocs are natural gamers. I did not know that. Espio said he saw Shadow entering the library car, but he's mentioned nothing about Shadow's return. He only mentions that Vector came back. When Shadow left Knuckles and Vector in the saloon car, Espio was fully seated, reading his book for a good while at this point. Yes, you've been caught out, buddy! We know Shadow had to walk back through the library car when he left the saloon car, so there's absolutely no way Shadow and Espio didn't notice one another in Shadow's return trip, which is true. I mean, it was a simple slip-up. I was just fully immersed in my book that I didn't notice Shadow. You're telling me that the sound of a door opening and locking wouldn't have caused you to look up? That is true. I mean, sure, I wouldn't care, but like, that would alert most people. Well, you see. It says Espio's desperation here, defending the argument that he was reading the entire time wasn't easy. So, if you didn't see Shadow returning from the saloon car to lock all the doors, then at that moment, were you really in the library car at all? He might have gone up to the casino. But how would Espio leave? Shadow locked all the doors and no one saw Espio in the saloon car. It's a mystery, my dear Eliza Lee, but one that I would love for Espio to solve. You gotta believe me. That cool demeanor is vanishing, so my guess, before we continue, my guess is that he went up, because if Shadow left, he might have left the doors unlocked behind him because he was heading back up that way while he's in the saloon car, so other doors might have been unlocked. So while those were unlocked, he went up to maybe the casino, maybe. So in Vault of my book, I didn't notice Shadow pass back through the library car. Honest! When Vector returned, he even had to tap me on the shoulder to get my attention. Yeah, I think I remember doing that. I must have fringed my friend's death, so I'll ask you again, Espio. If you weren't there for Shadow to see you reading, how did you leave the library car? I wasn't, I didn't. Why doesn't this seem right to me? Tails definitely feels like he's onto something, but I don't see it. Was Espio really sitting and reading, or did he somehow vanish and not notice Shadow's return into the library car? What should I do? Join Tails. No, I can't interrupt Tails while he's onto something. I'll let him continue the line of questioning and... My favorite and beloved employee, please, why is my memory so different? Protect the passengers aboard this train. They must be taken care of. If you fail, the lawsuits will be torturous. Don't allow such an old feeble soul to get sued. Okay, I don't remember that happening. Maybe this was an interview from before? I'm not sure. I have to make sure our guests are taken care of. I have to speak up. Tails. We have a piece of evidence that can answer all our problems. Alright, my fellow associate, lay it on me. A piece of evidence shows Shadow and Espio couldn't have seen one another. Well, we used the library map, so what about the library? The other one, what about the library map? Alright, now let's get my thoughts in order. So let's see, I'm guessing that's gonna be the key. The fact that didn't hit me is kind of shocking. Okay, we got 71 rings. Okay, that's good. That's a good amount. We only needed 55. The library map. Oh, I see. See the exit? Okay, that's good. I was right. Only two exits. See the exits? They're right across from one another. Straight path. Shadow walked down this straight path. There's no way Espio and Shadow could have seen one another. I mean, it looks like you have a point. You'll have to point out where exactly in the map you mean. Where could Espio have been for Shadow to not see him? This? There. Interesting. That's where I was sitting reading my book. I can second this. When I returned, the saloon car of Espio was in this exact spot. Okay. That confirms it then. You see, Shadow and Espio couldn't have seen one another from this spot because a bookshelf was in the way. Bookcase was in the way. There's no way Shadow could have seen Espio or vice versa. Okay, then. Well, there's my theory down the drain. It makes a lot of sense why you never mentioned Shadow's return, Espio. There's just no way you could have seen him. I apologize for losing my cool back there. I felt like I was grasping despite telling the truth. Which is fair, I mean, it's pressure. But I'm glad you all believe me now. Your alibi isn't the most airtight, but I have no further points. Thank you both for answering all our questions. Awesome. So, I don't know about them, whether they committed a murder or anything. We'll see. I still think it's a conductor. Too many locked doors to worry about, but I'm glad everything straightened itself out in the end. Sadly, our work isn't done. I have plenty of questions for Rouge and especially Shadow. Oh, it seems the door to the next car is open. Amy must have kept it open while she passed through earlier. Then that's our cue to leave. See you later, Victor and Espio. Give them heck. And if you need any meat chops, say the word. And I'll keep my poetry sharp for you both. Still trying to figure out what he is. A chameleon of some sort, maybe? A murderer is on the loose while doors keep getting locked. Tick, tick. Talk goes the clock while our heroes are in the caboose, which is the back of the train. At this point, I'm feeling pretty confident in our detective abilities. We're really doing this. Come on, Eliza Lee, let's see what's next. Coming, and off we head. Are you sure you don't want to stay and look at all the great books any longer? Mystery calls. Let's go. We can do this. We can figure this out, right? Oh my god, look at it. The tiny little one with the mustache. Rouge and Blaze are here. All this stuff's getting heavy. I'll dump what I don't need. Rouge, there you are. I have a lot to say to you. We visited every train car so far, and everyone said they've seen you wandering about. It's high time you told us why. Just got here, why is Sonic dead? I'm not 100% sure. That's why Tails and I are trying to investigate.
How are you, by the way? I hope you're having a lovely day. And we're, Tails and I are investigating and questioning everyone except for Amy since it's her birthday. And we're trying to figure out who killed Sonic. My best guess is Rouge was trying to steal from everyone. My, my. Talk about a warm welcome. Quick to the point, aren't you, darling? And I've seen you brought the Microwave Master with you. Oh, thank you. Yes, I'm so happy to have this title. Please don't let that be my legacy. Tails is right. Folks have bought you up a lot. Care to explain? Tell him, Rouge. We're gonna need the help. Blaze? Alright, I've been hunting for a treasure rumored to be stored here on the train. You certainly didn't tell me about a treasure in the interview. That's why I'm part business tycoon, part per... A fantastical day, thanks for asking. That's great, I'm glad you had a fantastical day. Anything in particular that you had fun with? Part purveyor? Purveyor? Of fine collectibles, and I knew I had to find it. Tell him what it is, Rouge. Alright, well, it's a Fabergé chow egg. Is that like those China looking egg things that are really fancy and you see like famous people have? Wow, that does sound extravagant. But please don't tell me you accepted Amy's birthday invite only to find that egg. A woman can have multiple goals. I gave Amy her birthday present already, so everything's well taken care of. A few friends and I went to play a soccer game at the park? That's so cool! Did you have fun? Do you enjoy soccer? She roped me in on the hunt immediately. I stayed here while she searched the train cars for clues. I deduced that the Fabergé chow egg is here, in this train car, locked in the up in a safe. Probably somewhere there then, if that is a chow thingy. Wait, so the treasure is real? It's actually here? And what did you manage to find, Rouge? Oh, well, why don't you both take a look? Okay, that's blueprints. I found the train's blueprints in the library car, which might explain why Espio was reading a manual. Maybe he wanted Rouge to find it. Yeah, like soccer? That's cool. I found the train's blueprints in the library car, with the safe code written right on it. The score of a lifetime. The train's blueprints? Please, Rouge, let us see that. Okay, so maybe Tails is gonna find another way for them to have quick travel? Finders keepers, sweetheart. Oh, damn it. There's a problem. We need your assistance. What kind of problem? Okay, there's a problem, as always. Figures. The elevator behind security guard leads us right to the room holding the Fabergé chow egg. So when you think about it, when you think- ooh, angel number anyway. When you think about it- I forgot, I lost my line of thought. But we're not getting anywhere without the guard's access card. Why is my brain not working right now? We need a plan to get that card to use the elevator. Okay, I accidentally clicked. So you want us to help you steal the Fabergé chow egg. And obviously Blaze doesn't have a problem with it. No issues here. Sounds like a fine business adventure. Her lore card must be influencing her decisions here, probably. Either that or breaking the rules must be refreshing for a princess. I feel like we're focusing too much on the princess. Do I have an opinion on this? Stealing is for squares. It's time for a 5-finger discount. Here we go. I suppose if both Blaze and Eliza Lee are here, let's get the Fabergé chow egg. Maybe it'll make her talk. That's a ticket. Happy to have you both here on the team. Okay, let's see how this goes. Now we must plan. Okay. Oh boy, what have we gotten ourselves into? We have to plan things? Okay. So I can't tell. So that's us. So I can't tell if we're a fox or a cat. Because like, Tails looks like that. Since we're rounder in face. But then again, Blaze... I'm not sure.
I'm not sure, man, and I'm giving up on trying to figure it out. Access to Fiber Drake Chowegg room is behind a locked elevator. The security guard has the access card. Do we distract the guard, bribe the guard, attack the guard? There's enough of us. Oh, but she doesn't feel comfortable attacking. Let's keep the violence to a minimum. Dull. Less fun, but fine. Okay. We bribe the guard. Does anyone have anything we can use for bribe? A pair of tweezers? I don't think the guard would want tweezers. Trading card? I'm not giving you anything. Fair enough. Maybe bribing is the best way to go. Okay, so we have to distract him. Distract the guard. We're all charming enough to make that work. That was actually a really nice thing to say. Which is true. Eliza Lee, is everything okay? I've never seen you smile like that. Seems like she doesn't know how to take a compliment, just like Knuckles. If I'm gonna be in a casino, my poker face needs to work. Duh. Okay, who's distracting the security guard? I'm guessing they're gonna put it up to me. Probably Rouge would be a good idea. Of course I'll distract him. Who could resist my feminine charms? I'm not sure how effective your charms will be on a kid, on the chow. Plus, your flight might prove useful. I'm not sure you being... You... Oh, okay, so maybe we won't use her. Well, maybe Tails is a detective, so he'll need to be the mechanic and looking for things like that. So I'm guessing we'll have to use Blaze, maybe, since she did say she's not comfortable attacking one. So maybe she has a deeper connection to one, to those species than them. So let's try Blaze. I think you could distract the guard, Blaze. In my life, I've never let a single person down. I will not falter. Great! Her voice is so stoic, I have chills. Okay, well, I trust her, moving on. Okay. What's the distraction? Push a bunch of poker chips to the floor. Ask the child about their partner and kids. Pretend the claw machine is stuck. Partner and kids. Excellent, people love talking about themselves. This will easily distract the guard. Okay, cool, we're making the right choices. Perfect. I think I can move on then. With the guard distracted, Rouge, how will you get to access the card? It's a lot of kids. Oh, wait, no, that's only three. Grab them and fly up to the rafters, ask for the card, pick their pocket. That seems like something she can do. I'll snatch the access key, no problem. That chow in uniform won't notice a thing. Excellent, we can count on you. Awesome, so that'll work. Because they did say that the flight would be a good, well, benefit, so might as well make the most of it. Try not to take anything else from him if he can help it. No promises. Okay, with the card obtained, we need to get Blaze out of there. Leslie, what's your plan? Pretend you're Blaze's spouse. Then you'd be marrying into a royal family. What is your heritage? Okay, then. Any war crimes I should know about? Oh, no. Oh no, well, just don't look on my Discord, because literally my Discord- Actually, wait, give me a sec. Give me a sec, I'll just get it up. I actually do have something about war crimes on my Discord profile. Look. War criminal. Oh no. Oh no, I don't think she'd approve of that. I'm not a literal war criminal though. But anyway. Any war crimes I should know about? Nope. What? Well, you dress far too plain. We would need a complete refashioning immediately. Yeah, let's try something else. I mean, who, like the chow would really know that she's royalty? Who really would care? Say there's a drink. Absolutely vile. I can't think of anything worse. Despicable. I would never allow such a thing in my kingdom. The guard will go running immediately. I'm sure of it. Really? Really? And just like that, I learned that your character is supposed to be a... Woka. Thank you. I actually don't know what that is, and I am now going to Google it so I know. not sure if I'm pronouncing that right. Puoka is a small marcopod about the size of a domestic cat. It's the only member of the genus Phytonyx. Like other marsupials in the marcopod family, the puoka is a herbivore and is mainly nocturnal. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, so it's like related to the capybara and things like that. That's quite cool.
And just like that, we all make it in the elevator. Inside, we pop some apple cider, sing victorious a cappella. All of that just does not seem like right, but sure, apple cider. Now that's a proper victory. Oh no, one less security measure we didn't count for. I love that of all things, it's just Rue. She just looks calm. I doubt Blaze would have eyes like that, but you know, that's chill. What do we do about the mechanical arms attacking from the ceiling? Have Tails tie them in one big knot, high five each of them. Have Tails disable them. I should be able to disengage them, we'll just need some time. Well, that leads us nicely to the next question. Oh no, Tails is taking a while and the arms are tightening their grip. Imagine you're not in pain, pretend there's nothing wrong, cry and hope they sympathize. What's with these questions? Pretend there's nothing wrong. Tails managed to do it. Okay, interesting. Darlings, I'm happy to say this plan is perfect. I'm beginning to doubt the plan. Dying from asphyxiation does not sound very appealing. Thank you very much. If everyone is ready, it's time to execute. I'm ready. Let's begin. All right, let's see what's up the elevator. We're almost there, guys. Well, I'm guessing. Okay, let's just look at our map. Where are we? We are here. We only have to get through to... Ooh, okay, so who's there then? So I'm guessing that's still the conductor. So the conductor's the evil one, so... That is suspicious. There's Shadow. Okay, that's suspicious. I knew the plan would go off without a hitch. We couldn't have made it this far without you both. You have my gratitude. Our planning beforehand was very thorough, I must admit, and it was a perfect plan to execute. And plus, Rouge is used to stealing from everyone. Enough chatter now, let's claim our real prize. We have the safe code right here on the blueprints. No question, this has got to be the safe with our treasure. Enter in the code in the blueprints and find out. Let's see. Oh, that's right, that is what a Fabergé egg is. Okay, here it is, I have it, and there's gonna be another trap, guaranteed. All right, before anyone sees us, let's get out of here. We can't be hasty, you truly think that's all there is to this egg? No further secrets whatsoever? Oh no. Only three of these eggs were ever made, each hiding in their own individual secret. No one knows the secret because anyone who's opened one of these has never lived to tell the tale. Oh my god, isn't that a sign you're just gonna die? You can open the egg? You sure can, and all of you bear witness to its secret. I don't know if you should. Yeah, I don't think it's a good idea. All you need to do is twist it. It's a bomb, isn't it? Uh-oh. Rouge, no one has ever lived to tell the egg secret because each egg is a bomb. Oh, that's great. I think you're onto something, kid. It sure does sound like a bomb. We need to dispose of the egg now. Just shut the safe and run. Dispose of it after all our hard work. Just steal other stuff then while you're there. Just leave it in the safe. Shut the bomb. Oh my god, there's so many choices. Twist the egg again, throw and lock it safe, toss the egg in the elevator, open it to see. Let Tails cool it down with this egg, let Rouge kiss the egg, tell the egg to stop. Charles control the egg anyway, let it finish ticking and see what happens. Flip the egg upside down, there's so many choices. Tell the egg to stop. Stop! That did nothing. Let Rouge kiss the egg. I'm just gonna go with every single option I can, delaying the inevitable.
They say love will always prevail. I still hear ticking. Okay. Flip the egg upside down? Who knows? It's nothing happy. We're trying everything. Stomp on the egg, set the egg on fire, smash the egg against the wall, take one for the team. Here, give it to me. Get as far away from me as possible, just remember me as I am a hero. I mean, if that's what she wants, who are we to stop? Okay, the microwave kid's not going to sacrifice herself, their body's too scrawny. Oh, oh my god, that's mean. Okay, eat the egg. Oh, it was worth a try. cool down the egg with its tail. Still here ticking. Toss the egg in the elevator, throw it. Twist the egg again. Great idea. Clearly not working. Rock the egg to sleep. Yep, it's cranky and needs a nap. Is this what you're telling us? Everyone's always mad with the idea guy. Set the egg on fire. Open it up and see if there's wires. Let's give it a try. Smash the egg, throw it in the safe and lock it. Toss the egg in the elevator. Let's just watch it ticking. Oh. What if it isn't a bomb? Exactly. Sorry, but SVO did say something interesting in his week quiz. Reads manual. Okay, let's see what he said. What efficient and extremely accurate technology is installed to assist in keeping the train spotless? Robotic arms during the event, they can perform a variety of tasks and are responsible for cleaning up trash and messes afterwards. Robotic arms can also detect weapons or explosives being brought onto the train, ensuring passenger safety. Oh, okay, so we're safe then. And that would be throughout the entire train. So if it's a bomb, then the arms would have been here. The robot arms that attacked us in the elevator seem to have a lot of function here in the train. If a bomb was brought onto the train disguised as this Fabergé chow egg, the arms would have detected it and wouldn't be allowed on it. That's true. The only other person who knows the coming and going of the train is the conductor, and he surely wouldn't allow such a thing either. But I still think he's the murderer of Sonic, so I mean... So if we're out of options, I think we should just wait and see what happens. Okay, we wait. Okay... The egg, it opened. It's hollow, not a bomb at all. Awesome, okay. You both are really onto something. I'm completely relieved. My hunch was right, thankfully. And look what's inside. What is inside? Oh, it's a little necklace. Wow, and look at that sparkle. It's so heavy, too. The final secret to the Fabergé chow egg is a chow covered in gems. It's perfect. It's exquisite. It's revolutionary. Awesome. Oh my god, I've been streaming for 2.5 hours. And this is the only game I played. Okay, is she drooling over sparkly ornament? Oh, I must admit, it is stunning. You said no one lived to tell the Fabergé chow egg's secret. I wonder if the egg wasn't a bomb. Maybe it's because the chow will be, like, attracted to it, maybe? What a precious treasure, a beauty to behold. Maybe they naturally died in old age and just kept the secret with them. That is a good idea. Okay. Awesome! We're getting there! We are getting there! We're almost there. And there's an arm fixing. No one seems to suspect anything at all, and the security guard is back at their post. Hope they subdued the drink coaster fiend. Thank you both for your assistance. The hunt was exactly the thrill I was seeking for. Okay. Stealing was strangely fun. Please, please, kids, don't steal. But yes, in games it's fun. But I think I prefer I never do it again. Now Rouge. Rouge? She's completely absorbed by that bedazzled chow. What? What is it, darling? Okay. About those blueprints, now that you're done with them, may we please take a look? Well, I appreciate your assistance. It says, finders keepers. I'll need them a little longer in case I missed any other treasures, but I promise to let you take a peek later. I don't want to sound ungrateful, but I'm sure you get it. Okay. Can't just add sweetheart to the end of a sentence to make things better. I mean, yeah, that's one method to make things better, I guess. But I don't think there's any reasoning with her. She's more powerful than me. Well, we'll get out of your way for now then. We have a murder mystery to attend to. Before you go, Shadow gave me and Rouge one of these. He passed through earlier. Another key. Just let me unlock the door so you can go forward. You know, we've had a lot of people mention you, Rouge. We also have just as much suspicion about Shadow. He's unpredictable, that one. Good luck to you. The door's unlocked. Both of you stay safe. Thanks again, but we didn't really ask for their alibis. Okay. I mean... Exactly, how are they being controlled? And only the conductor could control it. Again, that just adds to my thought of the conductor's murderer. Your alibi, we might as well before we leave. Do you think we could go over your alibi again, please, Gabe? Please? When Amy began the murder mystery, what did you do? Sure, we left the dining car and Rouge pulled me aside to talk about the Fabergé chow egg. We walked and talked in the casino car, and then when we went our separate ways, I scoped around and discovered the egg was here. After that, I played slot machines, the train did a sudden jolt, which was odd, but I didn't leave the car. Gave Amy her present. She stopped by, which we can ask Amy if she got her presents. Shadow passed through as well, but it was brief. He gave me the exit key and left. Interesting. Do you have any sort of proof you were playing the slots? I do, actually. I kept winning, so I saved the slot cash out voucher. You can take a look. 14,000 credits? That's an enormous payout. How did you... I'm just naturally lucky, I suppose. Okay, so I think I believe her alibi. That smirk, she's self-aware. Well, thank you for your time, please. Anytime, Tails. Do tell Cream I said hi, won't you? Well, I do know that Cream is another character, like a bunny rabbit, I'm pretty sure. Eggman, Robotnik. I suppose he does deal with a lot of casinos, so when he's an evil scientist. Okay, we keep seeing a theme of him everywhere in the arms, the robot arms. So that would make sense if Robotnik has something to do with this, I guess. Every poker chip I'm personally seeing has had Edmund's monk on it. I'm not too surprised to see this here. No, I do think that is sort of suspicious. Let's ask Rouge one more question. But first, might as well give it a try. Well, I lost. Do I try again? Yes, please.